It's me, Louie, here today in the studio checking out the Xhorse Key Tool Max Pro, Key Programmer and Generator. We're going to be looking into how to read remote frequencies, as well as how to read transponders and generate a remote using the Xhorse Key Tool Max. First, we're going to select Remote Clone from the main menu. Then, once inside, push any button on the remote to see what signal and frequency type you're getting. Now that we're ready, we're going to select Transponder Clone from the main menu, and then select Read Transponder to check out all the information that will fill up below, showing you whether or not your remote is clonable, what the ID number is, what type of chip it is, and other information you'll need to get the job done. We're going to try a couple extra keys right now and see what different results we can get. So along with reading the transponders, we can also clone them to a superchip, which is an Xhorse transponder made to emulate other sorts of vehicles, so it's easy to program and put into any sort of key so that you can get that key cut and programmed right away. First thing you do is read your transponder from the original key. Once you have the information, you'll have to place your transponder into the transponder slot, which is right next to the coil, and then press clone. This process requires you to be logged in to your Xhorse account and to be connected to the internet. So once you have all that selected, you'll be able to go right through the whole process and get an easy clone of your transponder. Next, I'm going to show you how to generate the four types of universal remotes available to the Xhorse universal remote system. First, we have our universal smart key, then our wired remote, super remote, and XM38 ID46 smart key. First, we're going to begin with our smart key remote generation. First step is to disassemble your key by removing the emergency key slot, then prying open the case to pull out the PCB board and insert a new CR2032 battery before you begin. Once the battery is inserted, push the buttons to make sure there is power. And from here, you can either stick the PCB board directly into the coil or reassemble your remote to get the whole remote into the coil before you begin. Once you place your remote into the device coil, select Remote Program. Then choose your car model. Desired remote, and select Generate once you're ready. Once your remote finishes generating, select complete. And then now we can head to the home screen to select the remote frequency tester to make sure that our remote is now sending a correct signal for the vehicle we programmed it for. Next, we'll move on to wire remote generation. Following the same preparatory steps as before, remove your remote from the packaging, disassemble it, and just remove the PCB board from the remote this time. Do not enter the battery. Next up, we're going to take our PCB board to S-Video cable that came with the Xhorse Key Tool Max Pro. Connect the board side to the PCB board at hand, and then the S-Video to the S-Video port on the Key Tool Max Pro. In our menu, we'll select Remote Program. And then choose the applicable car model desired remote. And then select Generate once you're ready. Once your remote has fully generated, insert the battery into the remote. Then head back to the home menu, select Remote Clone, and then make sure that the remote frequency received is the remote frequency needed for the vehicle you're programming to. Now you can reassemble your remote. Now you can reassemble your remote before moving on to programming. Now reassemble your remote and you can move on to programming it to the vehicle of choice. Now we can work on generating an ID46 XM38 remote. First, remove your remote from the packaging. Remove the emergency key insert. Then disassemble the remote case. And insert your new CR2032 battery into the PCB board. Check that your battery has power. And now we can either insert our PCB board directly into the coil or reassemble a remote before going on to generation. Next, select Remote Program. Then choose your desired car model. Desired remote style. Then select Generate when you're ready. Thank you. Now that a remote is generated, we'll head back to the home screen, select Remote Clone, and we can check to make sure that this remote is sending the correct frequency we need to program the vehicle. Now reassemble your key if you haven't already, and then head on to programming in the vehicle of choice. Next up, we have a super remote to generate. This is a special remote from Xhorse that has one of their super chips inside of it. Super chips allow you to generate a myriad of different transponder styles, giving you the ability to program keys for a wider range of vehicles, lots of keyed vehicles, different types of older styles of keys than your smart remotes you have coming out right now. First step we're going to do is, after we remove the back panel from the remote, just take out the PCB board and insert the brand new CR2032 battery. Now place the PCB board, then side down into the device coil, then select Remote Program. Scroll down the menu until you find the car model of choice. Then select your desired remote. And generate once you're ready. Once you're complete, you can remove your PCB board from the coil. We can place it back into our remote case. Once again, head back to the home menu, select Remote Clone, and test the frequencies of every button on your remote to make sure it's functioning as desired. Now I'm gonna head into the Generate Transponder menu. Now I'm gonna head into the Transponder Clone menu to go ahead and read our transponder and make sure that it's reading as a transponder type that we can program to afford. Everything looks perfect, so we're good to go.